All of you, welcome to the session. Today we are going to talk about thermodynamic temperature scale or absolute scale of temperature. See, according to Kelvin, he stated with the result that the efficiency of all reversible engine working between the same two temperatures is a function of two temperatures only and is independent of the nature of working substance. This outcome of Carnot's theorem forms the basis of Kelvin's absolute scale, right? So the scale is known as thermodynamic scale of temperature. See, again, the efficiency of Carnot's engine is independent of nature of working substance and it only depends upon the temperature of source and the sink. Understand, see there, the efficiency of Carnot's engine is independent of nature of working substance and is only depends upon the temperature of source and sink. So for this, so let us consider here the temperature of source is capital T1. So what I am doing, I am assuming the temperature of source is capital T1 and similarly temperature of sink is T2. Then heat absorbed by the working substance at T1 is Q1 and heat rejected by the working substance at T2 is Q2, right? So now the efficiency, we know already, we got this one in the earlier topic. The efficiency can be written as eta equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, that is equal, it is a function of temperatures T1 and T2, right? So from this one, Q2 by Q1 can be written as 1 minus F into T1, F of T1, T2. And let us assume here one more function, but the Q1 by Q2 equal to F of T1 and T2. Let us assume that is what equation number 1. Okay. So where F is new function of temperatures T1 and T2. Now let another reversible engine. What I am doing, I am taking another one more reversible engine, so it absorbing heat Q2 at temperature T2 and rejected heat Q3 at temperature T3. Then according to equation 1, so here we can write Q2 by Q3 equal to F of T2 T3, that is what equation number 2, okay, just like equation number 1. And similarly, what I am doing, I am assuming one more reversible heat engine that is working between the temperatures T1 and T3. Then, with the say just as equation 1 and equation 2, I am writing this one as Q1 by Q3 is equal to F of T1 comma T3. That is what equation number 3. Okay, now let us multiply equation 1 and 2. If you multiply equation 1 and 2, so what we get there, where Q2, Q2 get cancelled, then finally we have Q1 by Q3 equal to F of T1, T3, assume that is what equation number 3, and multiplying equation 1 and 2 will get there. Q1 by Q3 is equal to F of T1 comma T2 into F of T2 comma T3. But already from equation number 3, Q1 by Q3 equal to F of T1 comma T3. So that can be written as F of T1 T2 into F of T2 T3. Right? So since LHS of above equation doesn't contain T2. See there in equation 4. On the LHS, on the left side, there is no T2. So hence it is possible only if the function F is the form of. Here what I am doing, I am considering F of T1 comma T2 can be written as pi of T1 by pi of T2. That is equation number 5. Next thing is F of T2 comma T3 can be written as pi of T2 by pi of T3. Let us assume that is what equation number 6. Okay. Now pi is another function of temperature. Here I'm taking one more function pi, right? So now multiply equation 5 and 6, we'll get there f of theta 1 comma theta 2 into f of theta 2 comma theta 3 can be pi of theta 1 by pi of theta 3. So here finally we'll get f of t1 comma t3. See there, where equation number 4 is satisfied. With this, equation number 4 is satisfied, right? So from equation number 1, q1 by q2 can also be written as f of theta 1 t1 comma t2, that is equal to pi of t1 by pi of t2. Since q1 is greater than q2, pi of t1 greater than pi of t2. So provided theta 1 greater than theta 2. Hence q of t increases with increase of t. Let q of t equal to tau. We have q1 by q2, that equal to, sorry here, pi of t1 by pi of t2 equal to, here we'll write tau 1 by tau 2. So where the Kelvin scale of temperature, this is what Kelvin scale of temperature, the thermodynamic or Kelvin scale of temperature is that scale. The ratio of any two temperatures is same as the ratio of its heats absorbed and rejected by the reversible Carnot's engine operating between these two temperatures. So this is the topic.